Today's project is a breakout tutorial for our sewing circuits primer, available in labs. And I just wanted to take a little time to show you how to sew a conductive jelly donut switch. All you need for this project is some felt, conductive thread, and your makey-makey. So I'm going to take a roll of tape to cut my donut base, and that's just going to help me measure and get all of my donut pieces the same. We'll do the same for our frosting, and you get to have a little fun cutting your frosting shape. And then you're going to just fold it in half to cut your donut hole. And then you're ready to sew the circuit. So let's go. Depending on your thread, conductive thread can be kind of sticky. So I like to take about an arm's length of thread and I tie a knot at the end and begin sewing my circuit. You're just going to loop around the corner of your donut about 5 to 6 times. And then you want to make a running stitch to the center of your donut. You want these stitches to be really short and small. That way will keep your conductive thread from accidentally shorting a circuit. Once you get to the center, you're going to make like a flower type pattern so that you have a conductive spot to bridge the circuit. You want to make sure you tie the loose thread because you don't want to short your circuit. And then you just do the same thing on the other side. Sew 5 or 6 stitches on the edge, do a running stitch to the center, and sew another conductive pad. And then you're ready to test it with Makey Makey. Hook 1 alligator clip to earth and 1 to space, and then use your finger to test your circuit. If it lights up the Makey Makey, then you're ready to finish your donut. Mark on the top layer of felt the area that will connect the 2 conductive traces. Cut a small piece of conductive fabric tape for the top of your donut and use stuffing as your cushion for your donut. You're going to test it to make sure that the stuffing doesn't get in the way, and you might even want to sew some thread to hold that stuffing out of the way of those 2 conductive pads. And now you're ready to sew it together from outside in with quick little stitches. And you might even want to sew around the center where your button is going to make that connection. And to sew your sprinkles, now that you're done, you're just going to take some contrasting thread and sew through that top layer. And this will actually sew your frosting onto the top donut, but it will also make really cool, cute little sprinkles. And now you'll have a conductive jelly donut that you can hook up to your Makey Makey, 1 side to earth and 1 side to space or any button that you choose. And you can press it to activate it for just a moment, or you can flip your donut over and you can touch it with your fingers to show how you're bridging the circuit when you touch the 2 conductive traces. You're activating the circuit. Just the same as when the top button touches those 2 traces, it completes the circuit. To hook this up for a battery, you're just going to hook the positive side to the positive side of your LED, and then you're going to hook the negative side to the donut, and the other negative side from the donut to the negative side of the LED. And that's going to break your circuit until you press on the donut. To hook it up to Makey Makey, you're just going to hook your LED from key out to the positive leg of the LED and an earth connection to the negative side of the LED. And you're going to hook 1 side of your donut switch to a key press and the other side to earth. And you'll have a button that you can make sounds with, you can light up LEDs, or you could turn on a fan. Do whatever you want. Learn how to sew more components by going to the rest of this tutorial, available at labs.makeymakey.com.